So the main thing which was done by or proposed by experimentally proved by Morgan was linkage and crossing over, because Morgan performed experiment on Drosophila. He established the fact that eye color gene is located on which chromosome? X chromosome. So this is the proof that scientists by this time had understood already, that genes are present on the chromosome. So he proved that there is eye color gene. So eye color is controlled by a gene, and the gene is not present on the second, third or fourth chromosome, but the first chromosome of Drosophila. And first chromosome is the sex chromosome, and he confirmed it is present only on the X chromosome, not on the Y chromosome. If one gene is a part of the chromosome, other genes should also be the part of chromosome. Now we all know, for example, human has somewhere around 30,000 genes. But how many chromosomes do we have? We have only 23 pair, or you can say 23 chromosomes in a gamete, haploid number. So that means that number of chromosomes are less and the number of genes are more. And when we say that genes are present on the chromosome, but it is not the that we have 30,000 genes and 30,000 chromosomes are there. We have only 23 chromosomes. That means that there are many genes present on the same chromosome. So from here started the concept of linkage. If one gene is a part of the chromosome, other genes should also be the part of the same chromosome. So organisms have more characters or more traits or more genes than compared to the number of chromosomes. Obviously, that means each chromosome has more than one gene situated on them. So now the next is, he performed experiment, we'll be doing that, okay. After performing these experiment, he came up with the concept of linkage, and he proposed that how do genes located on the same chromosomes, they assort independently. Now imagine if there are genes on the same chromosome, but they are moving independent to each other. So under such circumstances, there could be two possibilities, that either the exception to the Mendel's principle of independent assortment, genes on the same chromosome have a mechanism to separate and cause the formation of recombinant. See, when we say two genes are on the same chromosome, then they should move together. But when we see the experiments, we find recombinants also getting formed. So that means that there is a mechanism with the help of which the genes even present on the same chromosome are able to separate and then undergo recombination so that variations are created. Now we already know that recombination or separation occurs in the concept of the synapses, followed by crossing over, followed by meiosis, the anaphase. But at the time, these things were not clear to the scientists. So he came up with the concept of linkage. And the first exception to the independent assortment, please remember, Mendel proposed, whatever laws he proposed, only one law is universal and correct. And that is the universal law. And that law is the law of segregation. Please remember, he gave the concept of a pair of allele. Today we know there are multiple alleles. So one exception. Another one he gave was the law of dominance. We have already learned codominance and incomplete dominance. Then he gave the concept of the segregation. That is the only correct law. It is universal law. There is no exceptions to it. Yes, mutations may occur because of non-segregation. It's a different concept. But universal law is but law of segregation. Then he gave the law of independent assortment. And today we are learning that even independent assortments also have exception. So the first exception to the independent assortment of gene was observed by two scientists, Bateson and Punnett. Remember, a few minutes back I showed you that 9:7 ratio, same scientists. So Bateson and Punnett in 1906 performed experiment with sweet pea, Nathyrus odoratus, and they found something different. They found that we have learned test cross ratios should always come 1:2, 1:2, 1:2, 1 in the case of dihybrid crosses. But what Bateson and Punnett found, that the ratios, the probability of the recombinants were very less. So you can see here, if you say 25%, 25%, 25%, 25% each, then the what we expected was that if there is independent assortment, then all of these combinations, blue and yellow, blue with round, red and long, red and round. So these were the parental combinations, and these are the recombinant. I have mentioned in the notes clearly. Please keep paying attention. Watch it again if there are doubts. So phenotypes, what phenotypes they chose for experiment were blue, yellow, blue color flower. The character was blue color flower and the long anthers or pollen grains, and the red color flower and the round pollen grains. When these experimental plants, pure lines were crossed, according to the Mendel's concept, there should be recombinants also. So those recombinants are blue with round and red with long. But if there is independent assortment, we expect both all of them to be formed in 1:1:1:1 ratio in a test cross. And if there is no independent assortment, then the ratio should be 50:0:0:50. Why? Because if they don't separate, these characters don't separate from each other, then they will go as such. They will go as such. So these recombinants are not possible. So when they performed this experiment in reality, they observed the ratio came out to be this. That means a very great deviation from the Mendel's ratio. Mendel said 25-25 each. They observed 43.7, 43.7, 6.3 and 6.3. So this confirmed that yes, genes undergo independent assortment, but sometimes what happens, there are possibilities they don't separate. That means they try to go together. So when will the two genes try to go together? When they are present on the same chromosome. This is the concept of linkage. So now next is, but when two genes are strongly linked, they will have more parental types and no recombinant types. When two genes are less linked or less close to each other, they will have they may have more proportion of the recombinant type. So let's come to the concept now, the concept of linkage. So this is the only exception we have discovered regarding the independent assortment. And what is linkage? Linkage is a tendency of a gene to stay together. Why are they staying together? Because they are present on the same chromosome.